Does anyone know who is this person is? What is her name?
Maxwell.
Who is this person?
Maxwell. Is it the lady who got killed?
This is one of the sisters who got killed on Thursday. Anyone knows her name? Anyone knows what is her crime?
She was Christian.
Her crime is to be Christian. Being Christian is a crime according to the teachings of Islam. Does anyone know who is this person is?
He's a teacher. It's the teacher. Simon Peter.
No, it's not.
Is it? Oh, sorry, I saw the picture.
He's the other brother in the church, okay?
She was a
Nadina from the church, Vincent, another brother from the church. Does anyone know what is her name?
I don't know her name.
She's the one who nearly got beheaded.
Another sister from the church who got killed, Simone. What are their crimes, people? What are their crimes? Their crime is attending the church and worshiping the triune God. In 21st century, it becomes a crime. It's not because you went and killed someone else. It's not because you robbed the caravans. It's not because you had sex with a child. It's not because you caused the breakdown the marriage of your son-in-law, son. But their crime is identifying themselves as a Christian and practicing their religion and worshipping triune God. That is the crime. 21st century, it is crime in England. 21st century, it is crime in France. 21st century, it is crime in Saudi Arabia, in Pakistan, in Germany, and in many nations. Why, how can this be crime? How can this be crime? Does anyone minds get it? I don't get it. I really don't get it. 248 people are being killed in France. 248 people. You know what is the reason? I would love to say this is the reason. No, this is not the reason. Let me show you the reason.
Subject access. We got my man. We got this guy. Subscribe to his channel. Very good guy. Very good guy. Check out his.
This is the reason. People are being killed because of those kind of pictures, not because of this picture. Are there any Christian who thinks this picture is offensive? This picture is Jesus Christ is simply saying, take me out of the cross. Death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ is essential to my faith. If Jesus Christ didn't die and he did not rise, I'm going to end up in hell. That is very serious. But people are making cartoon of it, and it is absolutely fine. None of the Christians wanted to go and hurt anyone because of those pictures. But simply drawing the picture of Muhammad and stating love is stronger than hate, causing the life of individuals. Approximately 248 people. That's a lot of people. A lot of people are lost their loved ones. A lot of people cannot practice their freedom of expression. Why? Because there is an ideology trying to shut down the freedom of expression. There is an ideology identifying me as a Christian, criminal. And my crime is not believing in Muhammad and not believing in Allah. That is my crime. And that was the crime of our brother in France. That was the crime of our sister in France. And that is again crime of my sister in France.
May they rest in peace.
And yesterday, Orthodox bishop is being injured, and his situation is critical. What is his crime?
Being Christian.
That is a problem. There is a problem. I see there are some of the pictures of Muhammad. You weren't able to walk so long for those pictures because there is an ideology's feelings are being hurt because of those pictures. I put this picture together. Theologically, it is correct picture. Muhammad offers salvation as well as 72 virgins for those who follow him. I identify this as the freedom of expression, freedom of speech. When there is a freedom of speech, there is a you will get offended. That is very normal. Especially if you are coming to speaker's corner, you will get offended because you have people who share different views from you. You will be exposed other beliefs, other ideologies, other thoughts. But that does not mean someone should be killed or beheaded because of such a pictures. It is wrong. It is wrong. All it has been trying to do is, let's take the life of individuals, let's hurt the people, so we shut down the freedom of expression down. That is the aim. That is the aim. Here's another picture from Charlie Hebdo, where Charlie Hebdo simply makes a theological point that actually responds to the question, responding to the statement that ISIS has nothing to do with Islam. And best false prophet of Islam simply says, I am your prophet moral, why are you trying to kill me? Actually, this picture supports the position of Muslims, many Muslims. But what is the problem is? There is an ideology, they are so sensitive, you cannot even critique them. You cannot even show the pictures of their prophet. If ideology cannot stand for the critics, cannot stand for the debates and discussions, there is already a problem with that ideology. If you are talking with Muslims, it is not funny actually. You know why it is not funny? Because this is actually, according to Islam, a true story. Man in his 50s thought it was all right to have sex with a child. That's not funny because that child had to go through lots of. She was only 6 years old when Muhammad married her, and Muhammad had sex with her when she was 9 years old.
Aisha.
Yes, Aisha. And Muhammad was in his 50s. Put your hand up if you think you would have sex with 6 years old child. Anyone would have sex with 10 years old child? 12 years old child? If that happens, people go to prison. Except you are part of the grooming gangs, of course. That is a bit questionable.
Yeah. Only one word for pedophiles, and that's death.
Another picture, which kind of turning the world upside down. Picture of Muhammad with his marriage, Aisha. This is not the Charlie Hebdo picture, but it is horrible picture. Poor child had to go through that. Poor child had to go through that. I am Christian, and by default, I believe Muhammad is false prophet. am Christian. By default, I believe Allah is false God. Amen. I am Christian. By default, I believe Islam is false ideology. Amen. And as a human, I believe teachings of Islam is dangerous. Not only non-Muslims, but even some group of Muslims. As a Christian, I believe that, sir.
Yep.
If you speak about all the
people. I'm not speaking to all the people. I am expressing my freedom of speech by telling you, as a Christian, this is the default. As a Christian, I cannot accept Muhammad as my prophet. I cannot accept Muhammad as the best example to humanity. I cannot accept Allah as God. Allah doesn't have a son. Do you know Quran teaches Lord Jesus Christ didn't die? Do you know Quran teaches Allah doesn't have a son? Quran comes and undo the work of Lord Jesus Christ. As a Christian, I cannot accept that. Therefore, I come to Speaker's Corner not to be part of a story, but I come to Speaker's Corner to tell the story of Lord Jesus Christ and keep Islam to account. Amen. Islam needs to keep the account. Why? Because it is really dangerous ideology. And some people from the Muslim community or the followers of Islam, not all of them, some of them cannot handle those pictures. Some of them cannot handle there are more than 30, there are more than one different Arabic Qurans. What happens in that occasion? Your freedom of speech is being taken away from you. Or you simply draw the picture of Muhammad, and next thing you know is your head is separated from your body. Or as a teacher, if you want to show the pictures of Muhammad, what happens next week? Your head is separated from your body. Why? Because there is an ideology which is very dangerous to humanity. I am very careful to not mix Muslims with Islam. There are lovely Muslims. I've got Muslims who can give up their kidney for me. I've got Muslims who can chop my head off. Muslims are human beings, they are individuals. According to my scripture, Lord Jesus Christ died for them. But what I am telling is, ideology of Islam is a problem. The book called Quran, here's the example of the book, which is causing some sensibility. I think everyone is so lucky. I don't have the book. So, what I'm saying is, it is Islam, it is the problem.
Amen.
This is the book called Quran. Calls me worst of creatures. Orders critics of Islam to be killed.
Yep.
Orders Muslim wives to be allowed to be raped.
And beaten.
Orders children to be married and divorced.
No.
Those who are yet to have their period. No. Those who are yet to have their period.
Yes.
To be divorced. And for that, first you need to have sex with them. It is allowing husband to beat the wife. It is asking me as a Christian to live as a second, even third class human being and have no rights. Identifying me as dhimmi, asking me to pay jizya. Asking apostates, people like me who left Islam, to be killed. Therefore, I strongly believe, and as a Christian, by default, I am forced to believe this book is very dangerous and it is a false book.
Yep. Amen.
And there are holes in it. You know why there are holes in it? Because for centuries and centuries, Muslims told everyone there is only one perfect Quran. until 37 different Arabic Qurans end up in this century. And Muslim scholars are telling us now there are holes in the narrative, we cannot explain it to you. The reason I have a problem with Islam because of this book. The reason I have a problem with this guy, it has nothing to do, he doesn't have the six pack. It has nothing to do because he doesn't like garlic. But it has something to do with his teachings. His teachings are very dangerous. Listen this very carefully, not for you, but for Muslim women. His teachings are so dangerous for Muslims who do not follow him dot by dot, letter by letter, step by step, let alone. His teachings for non-Muslims are very dangerous too.
Sorry, Hatton, one second. Can I just ask you again, just step back, create more space, please? I don't want this to be closed down for the COVID. Just create more space, thank you. Just move back a bit. Please work with me on this, thank you.
If anyone is so curious about the teachings of Muhammad, I don't want to put anyone in danger, but simply turn your face back and see that caricature. Simply summarize, writing simply summarize to you what happened, what kind of teachings Muhammad has. Please don't put the person who is carrying in danger, but that is the summary of Muhammad. Therefore, let me emphasize again, I have a problem with the teachings of Islam. And as long as we breathe as a human being, we should able to express our issues. People are expressing their issue that they have problem with Lord Jesus Christ. Every week at Speaker's Corner. People are telling me Jesus didn't die. People are telling me Jesus is not the Son of God. I'm not punching anyone. I am not calling anyone to be killed. Or I am not identifying anyone is committing blasphemy. All I am doing is, let me answer your objections. Because if we cannot have healthy debates, freedom of speech, I am afraid, is shutting down. And those of you who are British, who live in England, you are so blessed. You do have this open air where you can practice your freedom of speech, which you will never get in Turkey, where I am from. You will never get in Pakistan. You won't get in Saudi Arabia. But there is a certain community shutting the freedom of speech down simply with those pictures. I've been reflecting all week, and I seriously don't understand what is wrong with this picture. It is simply supporting humanity. I don't know, maybe they think Muhammad is not drawn handsome, but it is a comic. Maybe they think Muhammad doesn't have six packs. That shouldn't be issue. It is there for someone to express their freedom of speech and give their message. We cannot shut that down. As I said, I am not here to be part of a story. I am here to tell the story of my God. As a Christian, I believe, yes, by default, Islam is a false religion. By default, Quran is false book. By default, Muhammad is false prophet. But as a Christian, can you check it?
Yeah.
As a Christian, I also believe solution to everything, solution to everyone, is Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord God in the garden gave men and women practice of freedom of speech and practicing of freedom of action and expression, that men and women choose to sin against God. When you read the Christian scripture, you see how people insulted God. Not only that, Lord Jesus Christ, eternal Son of God, those of you who are Christian, or those of you who are part of the British customs, during Easter, we go through the story, what happens to Lord Jesus Christ as he goes to the cross. He's been spotted. He's been mocked. Yet he was willing to give his life for those who mocked him, for those who spotted him. He was willing to do that because there is something unique with my God. There is something in my heart of my God simply pours out for those people who are running away from him. That is the story I want to be part. I don't want to come to speaker's corner to create a story, but I want to known as someone who is telling the story of God by keeping also Islam to account. That is the issue. It is a false book. He is a false prophet, and he's very dangerous prophet as well. He did not allow people to critique him, mock him, or even engage with him. What he did was, he simply ordered their head to be chopped off, or he simply ordered them to be hurt. And that ideology is being practiced in this part of the world now. We cannot get rid of the ideology by abusing or accusing people, but solution to that ideology is only Lord Jesus Christ. That's what I believe. And he is the one who left the throne from heaven, stepped into this broken world, and gave himself for humanity. Not only he gave himself, but on the cross, he turned to people and then he said, "Would you be mine?" With his death and his resurrection, he offers us eternal life. There is no better place, there is no better offer.
Amen.
But the problem is being ignored. The problem of sin is being ignored. Problem of freedom of speech is being ignored.
Amen.
Problem of crime, problem of rape. Everything is being ignored.
Yeah.
Why? Because we cannot critique certain ideology.
Appease Islam.
Everyone can critique Lord Jesus Christ. People can even critique Boris Johnson. People critique Queen of England. People critique the President of France. But you cannot critique an ideology which doesn't even have a feeling. Why? Because feeling of one of the false prophets, Muhammad, is being hurt even though he's dead. And that is not acceptable. It is not acceptable. You cannot shut down the freedom of speech by punching people, by taking their materials or giving them death threat. Because it still screams out as Islam is false ideology, Muhammad is false prophet, and Quran is false book. That's all it is. And if you are here today for the freedom of speech, let me encourage you for something. We cannot shut down the freedom of speech. We cannot ask people to leave the country. We cannot order people to get hurt or even fight. Because we want to stand for the freedom of speech. We want to hear their side. And we want them to express their side to us. And it's not only the freedom of speech, but eternity of those people who follow this book. Because people who follow this book and people who follow this man, as a bottom line, is going to end up in hell. And everyone else who does not follow Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's all it is.